Hola, les saluda Lilian Roballo, editora del Empaque y Conversión. Hoy vamos a conversar de un tema fascinante y es el vertiginoso cambio o transformación que está experimentando el envase. Un envase que está pasando de ser simplemente un contenedor, un protector, un transportador, a ser un envase que tiene el poder para mejorar las condiciones sociales de las personas. Y hoy, ¿quién mejor para hablarnos del tema que David Lutenberger, tal vez una de las más importantes autoridades mundiales en innovación de envases? David, thank you very much for this interview for El Empaque en Conversión. A pleasure to speak with you. David, it seems we're living a very interesting moment. It is the moment to raise awareness of the role packaging is playing to improve social conditions and the quality of life. What do you think about it?
I think packaging has a very important role to play. The challenge we're seeing right now is that we need to get the brand owners to really step up, to work with the retailers, to work with the packaging converters, to really emphasize communication and education. We in the industry really understand the role that packaging can play to make consumers' lives better. However, that communication isn't being extended to the consumer. So they still see packaging many times as wasteful, or they don't understand the role that packaging can play to get food to people who really need it.
So you're mentioning that brand owners still do not quite understand the key role packaging can play to avoid the food losses and food waste.
I think the brand owners understand it. The challenge is there's so much competition for that billboard space on the front of a package that they just can't quite give up that space for that educational piece. It's still about marketing the functional benefits of the product or marketing the functional benefits of the package rather than educating the consumers on how this package could make their life easier, safer, more convenient, those sorts of things.
What do you think we could do to fight against the misconception that packaging is part of the problem and not part of the solution, mainly regarding environmental issues?
I think that the best thing we need to do, in my opinion, and the Mintel packaging team sees, we just need to continue to push recycling. I think educating consumers and giving consumers the opportunity to take action. Consumers today believe that a big brand should be doing more to preserve and protect the environment than they can do on their own. However, when the brand communicates clearly to the consumer that the value packaging brings to their lives and how that packaging meshes with their life and what they can do with that packaging even after its life cycle, after they use it, that's what consumers really crave today, is that we call it that hyper actionability. Consumers have put the impetus on the brands to do more, but they also respond to the brands when they tell them, here's what you can do as well to play your part.
Do you think the main action is in recycling? Or what would you say to these brand owners looking for this?
I think we always have to look at these next generation processes, next generation materials, the bio-based materials, compostables. However, again, the Mintel team really firmly believes that for the next 10, 15, maybe even 20 years, that recycling really is going to be that action that the brands can really work on to increase the percentages of recycled content, to help educate consumers on the fact that we're not taking advantage of our established recycling infrastructures, to create more recycling infrastructures, and again, help consumers take that hyper-actionability around recycling. Many times, it's very sexy for consumers when you say compostability and biodegradability, but they truly don't understand the differences in home composting or industrial composting. If I leave a Starbucks or another coffee shop with a compostable cup, well, what can I do with it? Can I recycle it? They don't understand these things. So I think that's what consumers are craving from the brands.
Okay. Now there's a big debate or a big conversation on ocean plastics, especially from what happened from Davos, the World Economic Forum, and all the brand owners joining, working for that. What is your approach, or what is Mintel's approach to this debate and this idea?
Certainly ocean plastics has captured the world's attention, it's captured consumers' attention, but I think many people are looking at it much too narrow. They're looking at it as an attack just on plastics, and the Mintel packaging team sees there's a much greater opportunity, there's a much bigger story. Consumers don't always want to talk about what brands want to talk about. Consumers are interested in talking to brands, but it's about the things that interest them. So we have the consumer's attention with this bigger ocean plastics issue right now. So why don't we use that as a catalyst to educate consumers and talk about the greater role of packaging, and not just plastics, but paperboard, metal, glass, and how we can be much more environmentally responsible with all of these packaging materials. And again, use that ocean plastics issue as that thing that's captured consumers' attention. They want to talk to you about that. So capitalize on that idea right now. And I think so many brands are just in a defensive mode thinking, oh, they're attacking our plastics. But they need to turn that around. They really need to turn this into a positive conversation and one we know consumers are interested in.
But it's always a pleasure. Thank you very much for this interview. Very interesting, David.
Thank you for giving Mintel the opportunity. We appreciate it. Thanks.